how that don't remember that. That's what I was saying. All you new chapters, all you coming members. Bruh, you fucked up. Honestly. You have fucked up. But I was on people taking away from the prophetic word of God. Yeah, man, you fucked up, bruh. Y'all fucked up. That's what I was telling you. See, when I was telling you, y'all didn't hear when you Donald Trump. Simon's and Nathan Yahoo, you too. The one Donald Trump, evil deeds. You're damned to you going to die. You're going to die, promise me. I don't give a fuck if you ban me. You need me. I'm the king of Israel. I am the king of Israel. I'm the anointed king of Israel, bitch. Fuck you. I'm going to ban you. And I'm going to let them kill you. You miss the 7 weeks, you're going to see Israel never be here no more. God is going to wipe y'all out. Iran's going to kill y'all bastards. Nigga, fuck you, President Netanyahu. Straight up. I'm telling you this. Fuck you. Fuck you, Israel. Fuck Israel. Fuck all of you, nigga. Boycott that shit, people. You feel me, man? You send us boycott that bullshit. That nigga's a bitch. Fuck them niggas, man. There's some bitches, bro. They will put people's lives on the line and say they love their country. Bitch, you don't love your country. Remember when Israel was built on nothing but prophecy, nigga? When you're supposed to make sure that the prophecies of God are fulfilled before anything, because that's what Israel is built on. You bitch-ass niggas. Straight up. Fuck them all. I don't care because I'm telling the truth. And people need to know the truth because everybody's telling me I'm lying. And I'm sick of everybody telling me I'm lying. And all I'm trying to do is point out the truth to people. So, bro, man, we can get saved for real, bro. And go to heaven for real. Fuck these niggas, bro. This is what I'm here for. I'm dead, bro. I'm a dead man. I've died. I'm just back to life, bro. This is my second chance, bro. But a lot of y'all folks are damn. Y'all newscasters are damn. I don't care what y'all niggas say. Your souls are damn, bro. Because you took away from prophecy. Once you do that, ain't no going back. That's why I kept trying to tell y'all niggas. Especially y'all CEO thinking about, oh, it's money for this pastor. I don't care what they say, bro. Because in the Bible, they cannot change what is in the Bible. Even they call me a liar from the day to tomorrow. You see what's happening. The war is not going down. It's getting escalating every day. The closer it gets to the 7 weeks, the more turmoil it gets. The more escalation it gets. The more escalated it gets. The more escalated it gets. You feel me? Just like King John Noon. You feel me? The more it got down to 20, see now he's shooting rockets everywhere. Everywhere, everything. Even Iran, they gave y'all 2 months that landed in September. And the end of the 7th week, exactly at the end of the 7th week. At the end of the 7th week. At the end of it. Everything, these are signs. These are signs, bro, that you people are not seeing because you don't have a spiritual eye. You don't have the prophetic gift. You don't have the prophetic eye, so you will not see it. But when President Netanyahu was there at the G5 or G7 summit with Prime Minister Putin and got on Donald Trump, but that was a prophecy of Daniel, where the two powerful leaders were going to sit down and lie to each other. That's why, my brother, look at the sign. But after the summit, guess what they Putin and Trump came together, ha, we friends and all that shit. As soon as they left, guess what? Trump went by doing his bullshit. Putin went doing my bullshit. Hey, man, this is so fucking funny, bro. I'm sorry, bro. But it's funny to me, bro. Like, it's funny, bro. Like, bro, it's not funny, it's serious. But it's funny because people been calling me liars for a long time, bro. Like, bro, they be telling me I'm lying. And all I've been doing is just waking people up. Bro, you feel me? Bro, I'm not perfect. I know I tell people I'm not perfect. You feel me? But I have a lot of flaws. You feel me? I'm not saying I'm perfect. I'm just guilt, you know what I'm saying? You feel me? I've learned to perfect my guilt, you know what I'm saying? And I've learned how to use my guilt. You feel me? Now, I've learned that, but me and my life, I'm still growing. You know what I'm saying? But I'm a young man, and it's very hard for a young man to please God, to even stay true to the path of God, even walk with God. It's very hard, because there's a lot of temptation. There's a lot of temptation I could be doing right now, and wasting my time, bugging myself, stressing myself to get y'all to understand this shit. Straight up. But I could be living my youthful life. But instead, I'm glued to the TV, trying to scream and shout. I'm spending all my time screaming and shouting y'all and trying to get y'all to understand this shit. You feel me? But I could be going out on dates, bro. Man, my girl left me because of this shit. Like, my girl left me. Straight up. But you know how bad I want to chase my girl and be like, babe, I'm sorry. But you know how bad, but I want to got to chase my girl and be like, babe, I want to quit this shit. Like, babe, I quit, man. You feel? I don't want to do this shit no more. Like, fuck y'all. Y'all don't even want to listen. Like, bro, why should I even lose my girl? Like, man, for people that don't even want to listen to the truth. Like, bro, like, why should I even do this? Like, why should I be like, fuck this shit, and just chase my girl? Because I love her. Like, bro, I never felt no way for nobody else before. Like, bro. She's away from me. She's away from me for good purposes. You feel me? But at the same time, like, but, you know what I'm saying? When she left angry at me. You feel me? And it's like, bro, it's like, except she, and like, and one of the reasons she was mad was because of what I was doing, how I was using my prophetic gift and going in on y'all niggas, cussing y'all niggas out, trying to get y'all attention. But I couldn't tell y'all nothing. I couldn't tell her nothing. Because if I gave her too much information, they're gonna kill her. Trying to get information from her. If I give my parents too much information, they're gonna kill her. If I give y'all too much information, I'm not gonna kill y'all trying to get information from you. So you feel me? I have to do it because y'all haven't mastered it yet. Y'all still in denial. Y'all don't wanna let go of the teaching of Jesus. So you really can't protect yourself if I give you this knowledge. You feel me? Because you have not understood and known how to use the prophetic word Emmanuel to protect yourself from the devil. And until you denounce that name and then sign this covenant and become my disciple and let me teach you, the devil's gonna kill you. They already twisted my teaching. And people, I'm kind of scared because, but if I use it, and y'all still believing in this man of God, they will lead y'all to hell. Cause look at everything they made y'all do to me, and my family. I have no ill intention towards y'all. I'm not doing this to get your money. I told y'all niggas, I make money off views. You know what I'm saying? That is an offering, you know what I'm saying? That's gonna be a blessing all the time I set all that up. You know what I'm saying? When I build my church and all this stuff. You feel me? Right now, I'm just focused on this views and my music. Like I told y'all, I have a talent. Like, everybody keep thinking it's about the money, bro. Like, bro, I'm already, like, bro. God got me, bro. Bro, I've never seen the righteous beg for bread. You know what I'm saying? Prophet Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel. Every prophet in the Bible, when I read the Bible, read from Genesis to Revelation, from Moses to John to Peter, you know what I'm saying? To Matthew. If even the 12 disciples, when they left, even Emmanuel, when he came, he had no money. He had no money. He had nothing but clothes on his back and his shoes on his feet. But when he taught the word of God, people came to him because of his teaching. People left the church and came to him because of his teaching. And they blessed him. He never asked for it. People blessed him. Wherever he went to, people blessed him. And that's why they mad. Because they don't have my teaching. Feel me? And that's why y'all attracted him. But y'all skeptical because your man of God or your leaders are the ones that you've been following, you've been disciples to, are misleading you. And they have your eyes blinded. They have your eyes blinded. And you don't see clearly. and you think everything they say is true because of the fact that they have a lengthy history in teaching the gospel. I've been teaching the gospel for 6 years. You feel me? I didn't go to Bible school. You feel me? I didn't do none of that. You feel me? I came out of prison. God gave me a gift, gave me a promise, told me that he was going to change my life. You feel me? And let me, you feel me, gave me understanding as I read more and study more and study and study, and I'm still studying. You feel me? I'm still studying the Bible. You feel me? And I want to learn the Quran. You feel me? But they stole my Quran. You feel me? But I want to reread into the Jewish law. But they don't even want me to be part of all that shit. So it's like, but I can't even follow my teacher. So it's like, what am I supposed to do? You know what I'm saying? But if I try to force myself, then they'll be like, oh, he crazy, Bob crazy, oh, he this, he that. So what am I supposed to do? You feel me? They kicked me out of the church. They told me they didn't want me to be part of them. You feel me? Until I denounced Emmanuel and see Jesus. No, I'm not going to do that. So y'all can have all that. Yeah, you can have it. I'm sorry. I'm not going to denounce my faith. Yeah, you can have all that. You know what I'm saying? If it's about the money, it's about the churches, it's about the congregation, all that, go ahead. Because it's going to be gone anyway. Yeah, God will take it like this. But, and that's what's happening in the rap industry everywhere right now. Because I believe the Spirit of God. And everybody that's doing evil to me, it's causing y'all to lose money. It's causing y'all to lose. It's affecting it slowly, but over time, you're going to see the big impact on it. Now, you see the big impact. Like, people used to go up to 100 million views, now you don't even see people on a million views because people don't even like music no more. Like, and people used to like trap music. Like, people don't even like trap music no more. Like, people used to like rock and roll. Like, even rock and roll is not making money no more. Like, you don't hear no rock and roll artists. But you don't even hear country. Tell, how long have you heard a country artist blow up? Tell me. How long have you heard a gospel artist blow up? And killing people? In the name of Jesus. In the teaching of Jesus. But what this man of God do, and what they do, bro, like, they think like they getting to me if they make people or make y'all say Jesus, 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 Jesus. I don't care how much you say. You feel me? I don't care what you say. I don't care what you say. Because even you've been saying, think about it. Y'all been doing, when we've been taught Jesus from the beginning of time. I just came out in 2013, and I made this impact. You feel me? And I've done all this stuff. We've been taught Jesus from the beginning of time. You've been teaching Jesus back then to now, but there's no difference. Well, you see the difference in my ministry. You see the difference in the understanding, in the teaching, in the comprehension, in the growth, in your building, in your faith, in your confidence in God. But even if you say Jesus, as soon as you say it, as soon as you say that Jesus, you try to make me back. When you leave from me, you back in the storm, in the storms of the world. When you leave from me, you're back in the storms of the world. You're back in the storms of the world. You're back in the storms of the world. What's up, homie? Hey, where you at? Yeah, my mom's still with you on. Yeah, they still want you to do it though. Let me tell them real quick. What you gonna charge Monson and you charge like 30? Alright, tell me, let me let my dad know and I'm gonna call you back and let you know. Alright. Alright, bye guys. Yeah, man, I'm going to say peace a lot. Bro, hold on, give me one second. Alright, bro, that's why I try to say peace, bro. Alright, bro, it's not about all of it, bro. Give me one second. Yeah, man, for real, that's how it works, so. And you have to understand, bro. Like, people are lying to you, bro. And because of your belief, bro, it's kind of hard, bro. And then, bro, I know that y'all want to know the truth. But, bro, what I'm telling y'all is the truth. And then y'all, man, and goddamn, we got your hands dirty. And y'all, man, and goddamn, we got your hands dirty.
While we connect
your call. Okay. Nine.
Yeah, man. Yeah, bro. Yeah, like, you have to understand, bro. And, bro, I got to tell you, man. Like, bro, you have to. Yeah, man, my dad said you come through and cut it. And when you... Alright, just come when you're about to come through. Alright. Yeah, man, but you ain't got no... Yeah, man, but people lie. Like, people lie to me, bro. Like, bro, if y'all niggas thinking I'm lying, bro. Like, but there's a nigga, like, a prison ministry dude, pastor, named Pastor Wesley Bonilla, Bonilla Wesley. You feel me? Like, ask him, bro. Ask him, bro. But like, bro, I revealed and told him the true essence. A plank came out of his eye. He couldn't find the plank. But there's a plank in everybody's eye. That's why you guys are blind. The devil put all those lies, all those deeds and shit. There's a plank in your eye. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I'm just trying to get y'all to understand, man. You know what I'm saying? The power of prophecy. Why prophecy is important. Why the name Emmanuel is important. Why his name is Emmanuel, not peace. And only when you believe you shall be saved, people. You know? But if I can't teach you, or can't teach much, you know what I'm saying? But when I get my own laptop, bro, see, this down the line, when I get paid, bro, if I'm gonna give me like two laptops, you know what I'm saying? But if I gotta give me two small laptops, you know what I'm saying? One for my teaching and one for my teaching and one for just, you know what I'm saying, for my school. I gotta have a thing. on my teaching. Because, bro, after 7 weeks, I would teach a few things, just elaborating on a couple things, you know what I'm saying, to the end of the year. And, like, bro, after 2000, I said, bro, when 2020 start, bro, I'm not going to teach anything. Like, bro, I'm not going to teach anything. So, it's not going to be no word. I might give you words of encouragement, you know what I'm saying, might uplift you, might give you a Bible verse, you know what I'm saying, from time to time. Or every 3 months, I might get elaborated on one Bible verse, just give you words of encouragement for the storms you're going through. God knows, you know, when you miss the 7 weeks, it's going to be way more harder than it is right now. Storms of life will come at you way more harder. You feel me? And like, bro, life itself will be hard. There will be pressure, like demons will be able to attack y'all and destroy y'all. You know what I mean? And it's gonna be hard, and you're gonna need some motivation. You know what I mean? And at the same time, like, bro, if the Illuminati niggas do start the whole thing and start doing their thing, like, bro, they'll start got them forcing niggas, man, they got them to sell their souls and all that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, bro, y'all have to know. Like, you have to know it. That's why I'm so honest. Like, bro, I've lost so much. Like, bro, all my money's been going to my music and my ministry. Just so I can reach y'all. You feel me? And it's like, bro, like, as I came out, bro, I've not bought nothing for myself. You know what I'm saying? Like, all I've done, I've dedicated my life to this ministry just like God called me and told me to do. You feel me? And please don't get me wrong. Like, bro, I'm not bitching or complaining about it. Because, like, bro, I love it. Like, I do it because I love God. You feel me? I do it because, you feel me, I love what I'm doing. Like, it would make able to move prophetically and move as a prophet is a great honor. And I love what I do. You feel me? So, it would mean spending all this stuff and not being able to buy nothing for myself right now. It's nothing. You know what I'm saying? Because my mom always told me, you clean the house of God, he would clean your life. You feel me? She always made it known to me that if I work for God, you feel me, that he would change my life and he would work for me. You feel me? That's what I want God to do. Like, but that's why I go hard. You feel me? That's why I go hard the way I do. Because I'm a young man of God. You feel me? That came from a troubling past. You feel me? And came through a storm of life. You feel me? And every day, bro, I am struggling to be better than what I am. And you understand me? And what I understand that I've learned, bro, you feel me? The changes in my life, I cannot make them change my life without God. You feel me? And, like, bro, I want God to change my life real bad. You know what I'm saying? And that's why I want to dedicate my life to serving God. You feel me? But at the same time, you feel me? I have to be true to God at the same time, and I have to stand for my faith and stand for the belief of prophecy. Because if I allow this prophecy, you feel me, change people's thinking on prophecy and what prophecy is, why prophecy should be perceived, you feel me? Then that's some great thing. That's a big whole deception. You feel me? Greater than this. You feel me? Then it's good than that. Y'all lost forever. But, like, you know what I'm saying? That's why I tell you, right? Like, man, you have to understand why it's necessary. You gotta understand why it is important. You gotta understand why you need it. Feel me? You gotta know something. You need God. God doesn't need you. You feel me? And that's how I think. He provides for you. He provides for all of us. You feel me? And it's like the whole world has forgotten to see God for who it is. You know what I'm saying? Because of false people and false, all these false people. You feel me? You feel me? The whole world has forgotten God for who he is. They have forgotten him for who he is. You feel me? And I'm just here to remind people. Now, everybody want to say I'm this and that. Bro, I'm just here to remind y'all that God is with you. You feel me? But I'm here to show you who you really are as people of God. And that's why I'm giving you the elaborate explanation. Because you have fallen through. Because you wasted your time, like I've been telling you. I told y'all that you waste time. I told you, you are wasting time, not me. You feel me? I'm not wasting my time. I've been diligent in my work. I've been teaching the word. I've been screaming and shouting. Instagram can testify. Even if nobody would testify. Like, bro, I feel like, if I even record myself and put myself on YouTube, Instagram, all this shit, bro, a lot of people would jump in line on me. You feel me? So, bro, that's why I record my shit. You feel me? Because all the people say all they want to, but this stuff will show God. You feel me? But even though God sees, bro, like, you just back up to show God, like, bro, I did what I did. You feel me? I did everything I did. But these people stopped me. You feel me? They did everything to stop me. And, bro, that's what I want to let y'all know, bro. You feel me? It's not that I hate y'all. You feel me? Because, bro, like, my job is to win souls. You feel me? You feel me? I get paid every soul I win. You feel me? So, bro, So, when y'all listen to this sermon, and y'all get understanding from it, and then you believe in the truth, and you see the truth, then you save your soul, because you want to save your soul, and because when you choose to save your soul, I get rewarded. You know what I'm saying? Bro, I get a heavenly crown. And that's my reward. Like I said, I'm dead. You know what I'm saying? I'm not doing it for the money. I'm not doing it for the money. I have a great talent that can make me trillions of dollars. Feel me? I'm in a $1 billion industry. But I'm in the entertainment business. And that's like a $1 trillion industry. People don't even understand this shit. Like, people don't know how to make $1 trillion off it. But I know, and I'm in the gospel industry, and I do computers. You feel me? All that put together, that's like a $1 trillion industry. The entertainment, the music, the computers, models, all that shit. You know what I'm saying? The ministry, and even the ministry, bro, like, people don't understand, like, these pastors are not supposed to be broke. They are not supposed to be broke. Why are you churches broke? Y'all are not supposed to be broke. That's why I tell you guys, like, bro, that's why I try to tell all you pastors, stop focusing on miracles. Stop focusing on trying to do miracles, or how you gonna get to do miracles to get people to come to your church. Emmanuel taught the word before he started doing miracles. When Emmanuel came, he was teaching the word. And when he taught the word and people started following him, they came to him to get the word, he started performing miracles. So first teach the word. First learn how to teach the word. First learn how to use the prophetic word to teach the word. That's why the Bible says the word of God is like a farmer, bro. That sows seed, bro. That's why God uses the parable of a seed and a farmer to describe his word, to compare his word. You feel me? He uses a seed and a farmer to compare his word. And the word of God is just like a seed. You feel me? And the word of God is like a seed. And when you teach the word of God, you are sown seeds into your life. You feel me? That's how you have to listen, see the word of God. So let me change the perception how you see the word of God. Well, when you see the word of God, it's from when you teaching the word of God, you are sown, you are a farmer. The people are the field. The people are the ground. And your words and your teachings are the seed. The word of God you're teaching are the seed. And when you speak in it, that's why you have to understand prophecy and how to use prophecy and how to use the prophetic word. So that way when you teach, you can prophesy those teachings into their heart. so more people can come. Stop worrying about this big man of God. They had to do demonic stuff to get there. All you men of God have not done all this stuff. Stop worrying about Pastor Tony, T.D. Joshua, Pastor Bala, Pastor Mike, all those Crepa Dollar, T.D. Jake, Jordan Steen, Myers, all the other pastors, all these big pastors, doing all this bullshit. That African pastor that did all that resurrecting the dead, that man looked like a demon. That's why that man looked like a demon. Think about why would a man raised from the dead be looking like a demon, acting like a demon, be raised up from the dead? He did that thinking he was going to get him a million views or get him a lot of views. He did that thinking he was going to get him a lot of views and get a lot of people to come to his church because he raised the dead. But he still ain't got nobody to come to his church. Did you see? So everything they do is really worthless. All that shit they be doing is worthless, is useless. You did all that shit. You did all that shit for people to come to church. But at the end of the day, man, look at this shit. Let me show you. South African pastor. Say how much he made it. You know, YouTube. Let's see how much he made. It's been a while now that he raised the dead, right? Consider the church, your church as a school, the ministry as a school. You are the teachers. Understand? Your congregation, your followers are your students. They are your students. They need to be taught. They don't need to be shown the power of God and miracles. They need to be taught to understand the Bible. The Bible is a subject. And let me ask you a question. How can a person that has a nursing experience, a nursing education, become a nurse, or a doctor, or a surgeon? They have to be taught that subject. Or that particular field. They have to be taught that subject. Or that particular field. And you guys are not teaching them. You worried about something else. You worried about miracles. You worried about performing signs and wonders. Teach them. People willingly go to school because they want to be taught. And every day people are going to school to learn something. If you teach the people, if you teach your congregation, you stand on this word of God, you feel me, and teach your congregation the true meaning that God is with them, and why it's important that God is with them, you feel me, you will not lose disciples. You will not lose people trying to learn. You understand? Teachers don't lose students. Students come to class every day. And more students come to class every day because they know that's the only way they can advance. So if you teach them like I'm teaching you, a lot of people will come to class. A lot of people will come to church and learn because they want to be taught the word of God. Not your words, for God's word. How God's word implies to the lives. How God's word applies to their everyday lives. They want to learn and know how can they use God's word to fight the devil. They always hear y'all say, use the word of God to fight the devil. Use the word of God to fight the devil. But you've not taught them how to use the word of God to fight the devil. That's why the people don't know how to fight the devil. You've not taught them how to stand on the word of God. You've not taught them the meaning of the word of God and the mysteries behind it. If you spend your time in seeking wisdom and understanding first, you have to understand wisdom. You have to understand the Bible. This is a book of knowledge. You have to understand this Bible, the book of knowledge, the Quran, the Jewish law, the teaching of Buddha. But you got to understand this Bible and the Quran first. You have to read this Bible first. And then when you understand who God is, you read the Quran, you understand yourself. The Quran teaches you about yourself. All these four books together are the perfect to make it a perfect being. Making you perfect and whole. Making you able to control the flesh. That's why a lot of y'all don't know how to control the flesh. And the Muslims do. But a lot of Christians are arrogant and ignorant. And they say ignorant shit. For real, they do. Like some Christians say, oh man, Moses is not a religion. Bro, do your research. Do your research. It's not part of Christianity. Do your research. That's arrogance. That's stupidity. They saying it just to say it. For just to make people hate them. Moses is a religion. You feel me? They think that if they put down the Muslim religion or the Jews or the Buddhist teaching, if they get more people to be Christian. No. People need to know all the books. But let them choose what book, which one that they relate to the most. Some people might relate to the Christianity side. Some people might relate to the Muslim side. Some people might relate to the Jewish side. Some of them might relate to the teaching of the mind more. You feel me? But they need to understand all four of them. And they need to understand this right here. So that way they'll know how to use the Spirit of God and all other teachings to better themselves. Once you activate the Spirit of God and use all the other teachings to better you, you have to understand yourself. And that's what I'm trying to bring to the game. Realization of self, and when I say be yourself, friend. Be yourself, realizing yourself. Realizing who you are as a man of God. What does it mean? What does that phrase mean, the man of God? Man of God. What does that phrase mean? Then when I tell this false man, then when I tell all you false men of God, you already fucked up and you don't even know. But you made a government and he's running news people, damn they soul. And they're mad. They are mad. They are mad. Because they did not know that them hiding the temple being Jerusalem being rebuilt. Them hiding Jerusalem being rebuilt. But it's going to put them in a book of, it's going to take them out of the book of life. Y'all told them to hide. And when they realize that, when the prophecies start coming to pass, they gonna turn on you. See, everything will get real. It will get real at the end of the 7th week. The closer we get to the end of the 7th week, the realer things will get. And it might take time sometimes to build itself up. But when it happens, man, it's gonna be a lot of chaos. I'm telling you now, it's gonna be a lot of chaos. For real. Right. It's not like a nigga trying to say this or say that or do this or do that. Bro, I don't care about this shit. You know what I'm saying? I don't care, bro. Okay. But I don't give a fuck. I don't give a damn about none of this shit. Cause I know I'm a hustler, I can make my own money. I mean, cause you bro, I can wait, bro. You know, in a couple of years, 3 years, 5 years. I know these rappers can't make music for their own. I know they're gonna stay there long to make music, bro. In 2, 3, 5 years, they can't. Making the music they make, that trash ass shit. But you know what? You can't tell people shit, cause they making money. You feel me? And they got a deal, and they got a van. So they feel like they shit. And, but the labels are steadily taking hits, cause they keep giving out all their advance. But the artists are not making all their money back. You feel me? They're not making all their money back. Or they probably get a promotion. Or they have to put a lot of money in to promote. You feel me? Like, bro, another thing, bro. Another thing I'm trying to tell you. I mean, this nigga did all that shit. Raising the dead. He didn't even get a million dead. A million people didn't even look at. So please, stop chasing miracles. Man of God, stop chasing miracles. Chase wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. When you get that gift of wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, and you start understanding the Bible, and then the more you understand and you grow, you start getting other gifts. And by the time you know it, you'll be like me, healing people, speaking in tongues, prophesying, probably singing some songs. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? When y'all niggas sign this stuff, it's gonna be 144,000 of y'all people, or the people, it's gonna be from the people, or some of you men of God. You feel me? And so y'all gonna be singing in tongues. This, so que na se na cho ki satane ka se chone ni ka se ni akana ni ki se te ni ka so makane ke e shani ka kami ka se itane atrani ka se toni ka se toni ke si akase Jehovah Allah Hine Sabi A Emmanuel Kevitana Nike Shaniki Ake Kani A Sabi Kasi Panu. See, you be able to do that, cause y'all gotta know a song. You feel me? And we all gonna sing together. That's why I'm trying to get y'all. I'm trying to get y'all to tap to the Spirit of God so we can come together. And we could pray on the name of Emmanuel. And then we could find 144 that are chosen. And everybody else that want to work on the ministry. And when we come together in the name of Emmanuel, then the real song will be revealed to us. And then people going to be chosen to sing in tongues with me. And I will start the song off. And I will be singing. And as I sing, if we pray, if y'all pray, we'll put on the name of Emmanuel. Then people going to start catching the Holy Spirit of God and joining in singing songs with me word for word. And that's how we're going to pick. The angels are going to pick who's man who's singing it word for word. They know it word for word with me on the spot. On the spot. It's going to be on the spot time. And you're going to be singing in tongues. Like just like I just sang. So that's what I'm trying to get y'all pastors. If y'all pastors really want to see the truth, the power of prophecy, faith of a mustard seed. Okay, even if y'all people, congregation people, for 30 days, for the last 30 days, the last, and you maybe wasted a lot of time, even governors, everybody, for 30 days, you want to see it, denounce Jesus and start teaching Emmanuel and confessing Emmanuel, God is with us. And tell me how you feel for the next 3 weeks, two more months. And after that, you will not feel again. But when the sign is coming, we can do everything else. And while we need the man, we can do everything else. You gotta do the first step. Because I've got demands to be met. Everybody, one of them got signed, everybody signed everything over to me also. But like I said, bro, I don't have nothing to say, bro, right? But that's all I have to say to you, bro. Faith of wants to see you, bro. But I'm not asking you for that. You know? So when you watch this video, I'm gonna make money. So I don't need to ask you for money. You know? When you want to study my teaching and watch my teaching, you know what I'm saying? I'll make money. You will see my music, and my music will be in my teaching. So that way you can click the link to my music if you can listen to my music. You feel me? And when you do that, I will make money. I'm not worried about that. I'm not worried about that. See, that's why I tell people that my shit is hot and stiff. But I'm not worried about that. I need y'all to see the truth. I need your faith of a monster see it. So we can come together and bring the Spirit of God down for real. That's what I want y'all to do. And when we do, when y'all sign this covenant, sign everything over to me, I'm all in here demand. And we do that, then you tell me what is real and what is not. Well, you have a 30-day pass. Starting day, the 18th. Plus, I'm gonna start tomorrow because the day's almost gone. Starting tomorrow, the beginning of next week. Bro, I love y'all, man. I love all your pastors, you know? And, bro, I know that there are a lot of false men of God, but what made me want to be a man of God, but the God I admire you, y'all man of God. You know? Until I found out that a lot of y'all are false. You feel me? But I admire a lot of y'all. And I still do admire a lot of y'all man of God. You feel me? And I admire how, like, a lot of y'all kept the gospel down. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, they be misleading y'all. You feel me? But bro, I want y'all to see the truth. You know, and people, I want y'all to know something. I know a lot of this false man of God people are gonna keep being denied. Let them be denied. Cause the book and Daniel 12 said within that people will deny it, then we can keep being wicked. But then, righteous, you understand? Yeah, so you have a righteous heart. If you have a righteous heart, see, like Daniel 12, verse 10 said, many shall be purified and made white and tried, but the wicked shall do wickedly, and none of the wicked shall understand, but the wise shall understand. So I'm talking to all you wise men of God that are out there, all you righteous men of God that are not down your hands and do dirty things. I'm talking to all of y'all. Let the wicked be wicked. Let the ones deny it. Let them keep denying it. I'm talking to the wise men of God that see the truth in my knowledge. If you can see the truth in my wisdom, if you can see the truth in my understanding, if you can see the truth in my knowledge, even you government members, if you can see the truth, I ask you, God, to meet the same truth. That sign is coming. Let's do the right thing, people. Please. Bible prophecy is not something to be played with. And I believe in the Bible. With my life, my soul, everything. I died for the Bible. died for my belief in the Bible. That's why I got shot by my man, Emmanuel. Honestly, because I died for my belief in the Bible. Right here, you see that? I died for my belief. I died for my belief in the Bible. I died for this Bible. And I don't mind dying because I'm not concerned with death. I'd rather die than serve the devil. I'd rather kill myself and not make it at all than serve the devil. I'd rather not make it at all to heaven than serve the devil. And if you didn't serve the devil and not make it at all and burn for eternity. So you wise men of God, they have a wise and understanding heart that can relate and grab a concept of what I'm trying to say and what I'm talking about. I pray that you guys see this word from worldliness, from men of God, worldliness, everybody around the world. I pray in the name of Emmanuel that the Spirit of God is with me, that y'all see these words, and y'all see the truth in my words, and you consider the truth in my words, and act accordingly so we can save souls and not be caught up in the desolations. People, we're going to fall, but you don't want to be desolated. But I'd rather a miracle fall than total desolation. Yeah. Now, praise the miracle, God will be like, oh, he a terrorist. Oh, he a terrorist, he's supporting Persia. Oh, he a terrorist, he want America to fall. But how am I a terrorist, being a man of God? How am I a terrorist, telling you about Bible prophecy, and telling you that the Bible prophecy will come to pass, and supporting who God has told me to support based on this prophecy? If I didn't have no biblical ground, you know what I'm saying, to stake my claim, then you might say I'm a terrorist and debt my past. You know? But I have biblical grounds. You feel me? And if you government want to come lock me up for a terrorist threat, I could show you in the Bible, reading the CNN, everything. Right? I'm not trying to be like, oh man, I hate America. I love America. I love white people. I love black. I love everybody. America, see, bro, see, you know why I love America? You know why I love America? I love America, and people be like, I don't, because of biblical facts, of biblical prophecy. You know why I love America? Because it has taught me not to be racist. He has taught me how to truly be a man of God. He taught me freedom. He taught me freedom of the mind. He taught me the importance of education. He taught me the importance of rights. He taught me the importance of being a man of God, being myself. You know? I'm myself. Because what I've learned from every culture in America, I've learned from the whites, and I've learned from the blacks. I've learned from Asians, Puerto Ricans, the Mexicans, you know what I'm saying? The Arabs, the Europeans. You know what I'm saying? Even the race of white people, I'm not, so not to be racist. And as a man of God, I've understood the concept. You feel me? And but don't get me wrong, I love you. But at the same time, as a man of God, if I don't tell you, America, the truth, how can I love you if I see the prophecy of God come to pass and I deny it? Then I don't love you. How can I love you if God tells me to give you a warning? And I act like this man of God, and I give you the warning, then I don't love you.
Understand? This man of God did not bless you. And it made you blessed in your soul. And now you drumming official and all you newscasters and knew that Jerusalem was just built on July the 27th and you took that away from the people and you took that away from them because you not want me to be famous and want me known as a true man of God. You have damned your souls. And you might be like, oh, he lied. But one thing I need to ask them, and they say I'm lying, ask them to prove you, prove it to you, that I'm lying. Ask them to prove it to you. Ask them to prove it to you that we are not at the same 2 weeks. When you've missed 62 weeks, ask them to prove it to you that we are not in the 72 weeks. Ask them to prove it to you. Ask them to prove it to you that I'm lying about the word of God. Ask them to show you the signs of prophecy. All this man of God, all this so-called man of God, they call themselves apostles, prophets, because they do miracles and signs and wonders. So they call themselves apostles and prophets. Now tell them they truly had a gift of prophecy. Tell them to show you the same signs of prophecy that I showed you. I'll give you understanding to the 70 weeks if they truly have that gift. I'll give you wisdom, knowledge, and understanding they truly have that gift that they claim to have in the name of Jesus. That it claims they have gotten in the name of Jesus, people. Think with me, people. Stop being led astray. Stop letting people play you. Think with me. I'm not here to hurt you. But I will destroy you when the time comes. I am the destroyer, people. I am the man of God, and I'm the king. And I'm the destroyer also. And I'm the rebuilder. I'm the only one that can lead you into eternal righteousness. I'm the only one that can lead you into eternal righteousness. And eternal life. I am. I'm the one that's for the anointing. They have to anoint me. You have to do it for me. 4 more weeks. Within 4 weeks, I have to be anointed. The covenant has to be signed before I get anointed. You have to be on my unlimited demand. In 4 weeks, you must anoint me because you refuse to. That's another damnation. And if you follow this man of God and refuse to do it, I'll let you figure it out yourself. Listen, I'm not trying to be rude. I'm not trying to be disrespectful. But I have to call a spade a spade. You understand? I have to call it a falsehood. Because that's the only way people will be able to identify the truth from the lies. Somebody has to go against them. It's just like the Democrats and the Republicans Trump. The Republicans support the dumb shit Trump. They blindly support it. And the Democrats are going against it. Because Omar, Elon, all of them are going against it. You know? The Republicans supporting Trump, even Prime Minister Israel, because he does, because they want to get out of power. They don't want to be in the power for him. And I'm supposed to be in Israel right now. I'm supposed to be in Israel in a temple, in Jerusalem, in a temple, and building a temple in Israel right now. Say to me, we're supposed to be doing this. I'm supposed to be king of Israel right now. But they don't want to give up their power. Because they think if they don't give it up, because Trump has probably told the Netanyahu or whatever, oh no, don't give it up, or we're just going to force him to do this, make him look crazy. Dude, at the end of the day, bro, Trump, you're in a hot seat. You're already down. So everything you do, your family already been down. So everything you do is just one replacement. All the plagues in that book will be added on to you. And when the time comes, I will prophesy against you. That's how I'm going to kill y'all. And people like, bro, and the boy said, he's going to kill us, he's going to kill America, or he's going to kill the American government. Yes, I'm going to kill the American government. I'm going to kill all the American government. I'm going to kill y'all by prophesying against y'all, like I'm doing now. I will prophesy the plagues of the Bible against you. I will speak it into existence. Do you understand me? I have the power, but just the time is not coming. I have to wait for the time to come. I have the power to. I can prophesy against y'all now. And that's why I prophesy against all this stuff you do to hold back. That's why y'all not going nowhere. The entertainment business not going nowhere. Until I succeed, they're not going nowhere. Until I get my views. Till my views go up, ain't nobody finna do shit. They be like, oh, people make money. Think about it. How many artists in the industry are really making money? Do your analytics. Do your analysis and statistics. It's only a handful. You can count a handful of people making money. And they're just making that money. And they're not making a lot. You got half of it. Even in the gospel industry, you don't hear about no other gospel artists. You are not. Even the pastor, even all these pastors, but they think like mere signs of wonder, signs of wonder, signs of wonder. They're not getting nowhere. They are fighting for people to come to their church. They go through doing evangelism, but people don't listen to them. People walk away from them. Do you know how I know? Because I used to be on the block with all the hood niggas, or the street niggas. I used to be on the block with all the trailer park niggas, people, white boys. The trailer park girls. And when all the evangelism people used to come, remember, I'm a phony. I don't know the ways of this land. So I used to hang around them and just observe. And what I've observed is, every time your evangelism comes to the hood, or a business person, or even educated people, but they just don't have interest in listening to them. Even the Jehovah's Witnesses. All of y'all, they don't have witness in listening. But they don't want to listen to y'all. They either walk away from you, or they be like, oh, this shit is bullshit. Or they either don't close it, don't open the door for you. Especially y'all Jehovah Witness, y'all need to go out there and teach them all this stuff. Yeah, especially y'all evangelists, y'all go out there passing, people don't even take your stuff. But you are scared and you are worried about why people receive my word. Because I'm telling them something and they've been praying for it in hell. When I come to them, I tell them, the name of God is with you, the name of Emmanuel. And when they hear that, they soul rejoice. They soul rejoice. Like, oh, God is with me. Yes, God is with me. And I tell them, yes, that name Emmanuel is not Jesus. And they be like, why? Because Emmanuel means God is with you. Emmanuel means God is with you. You understand? And that's what God wants you to know. He wants you to know that. Because that was the devil coming. That's the first thing. See, that because you know what? That is the point. Because that's the first step to break your faith. That's the first step to break your belief in God. That is the root. You see, you cannot kill a plant unless you take the plant and the root out of the ground. You understand? You understand? You understand what I'm saying? God is with us. It's your root. It's your root into the ground for you to grow in the Word of God. The reminder, the knowledge, and a reminder that the Holy Spirit of God, you have the Holy Spirit of God with you, is what keeps your belief in God. It's what keeps you firm, keeps you to stay down through the storms. But when the devil comes and uproots you from your root, see, but he cannot, see, but that's why he can't uproot me, because I'm firm in it. And this pastor's coming up all this line, trying to quote all these Bible verses. Bitch, I know the Bible, too. That's why I'm quoting this Bible verse, showing y'all niggas. Like, bitch, this is the Bible verse. This is what the Bible verse says. That's why I'm breaking it down. Like, it's like, bitch, fuck all this. It's just a few Bible verses. Now, others, if I wanted to, I could start from Genesis down to Revelation. I'm just not going to give it, because that's too much knowledge to put on the internet, and people just stealing my knowledge to teach y'all. They got to mislead y'all. And I'm not going to encourage that shit. You feel me? So, I'm just going to take pieces of it. You feel what you need, you feel me, to rebuild your faith. You feel me? What I'm doing, I'm just taking the important scriptures that you need, you feel me, and the stories that will help rebuild your faith. Remind you that God is with you. You feel me? Because I have to start on the roof. I have to plant you back into the ground. Because the devil is your root, is your faith. And you cannot have the devil uproot you, because he told you that God is not you. He told you that God doesn't love you no more. He told you that because you're suffering, and because you're going through the storm, God must have forgotten about you. And you believe it. And you believe it. And you have believed it for years. And even you men of God, even all you other men of God, you feel me? They haven't done the much signs and wonders. They haven't made money to teach you Jesus. And you probably came into the family to a meal, but those men of God have made you feel like, but those men of God, they have made you feel like God is not with you. Because you're not doing miracles. Because you're not doing miracles right now. Because you don't have a big church right now. Make you feel inferior. And they don't put in you. And not all you guys are chasing is congregation. How to get congregation. You left your hunger for how to teach the word. And how to perfect your teaching in the word of God. And how to perfect and get the understanding to the word of God. To want the miracles. And you do anything for miracles. Because they made it a law that if you're not doing miracles, or if you're not doing this or doing that, you cannot get congregation, not get people following you. They normalize miracles in the game. They make people think that miracles are the powers of God. If you don't have miracles, if you're not performing miracles, you are not a real man of God. And I'm telling you, that's false. And you can be way better than that. And you can get way more people just by teaching the word alone. And I can show you this. But you first have to sign the congregation, sign the covenant, be on my demand, and sign everything over you. That's the first step. And then when you, and then when you sign the covenant, meet on my demand, sign everything over you, sign the covenant, then I'll make my demand. And you'll meet, and then I'll start teaching. And by teach you, I'll make my demands forever. You know what I'm saying? That's what it means, right? That's what it is. Right. It's not that. Believe in yourself. Believe in yourself. Believe in yourself, people. Believe in yourself. For real. Believe in yourself. What's up, homie? Alright. Let me know when you get to the house, when you get to my spot. What you want to do now? You want to let me know that when you finish cutting the grass? Alright. Alright, cool. Yeah, let me know. Alright, cool. Thank you. Girl, like, but they want to thank Mr. Benel, man. Benel, Wesley Benel, man. Cause that man has showed me, bro. Like, bro, he believes, bro. Ask him. Like, when he went for a phone cutting prison, ask him about me, bro. And he'll tell you, bro. He's seen my teaching. And he'll tell you how my teaching has changed his life. Like, bro. Please don't get it like I'm saying it. Make it seem like I'm better than y'all. I'm not better than y'all. Nope. The Bible says, flag go astray with counsel. You know what I'm saying? Y'all can help me be a more better man of God. You feel me? See? You feel me? Y'all, men of God, been in the industry for years. Feel me? You can help me be a more better man of God, and I can help you build your faith. See, we can walk hand in hand. You can teach me, I can teach you. Teaching is a give and take thing. You teach, I learn. And when I'm learning, you teach. When I teach, you learn. You feel me? And you can point me in the direction on how to really take over the ministry. You feel me? The ministry and the family or whatever they call it. And you feel me? You can show me the in and out of the ministry. And bro, I can. And we can go against this man of God. And I can use my talent, my music, and make the money. And take over the ministry here. And kick all these false men of God out. You feel me? But at the same time, before I can even do all that with y'all, you have to deny the teaching of Jesus. Because I'm not going to denounce man. And I'm not going to fuck with you if you're teaching of Jesus. And you are not part of me if you're teaching Jesus. And I don't want nothing to do with you if you're teaching Jesus. Period. Because you're teaching false teaching. And now that you know the truth, and you still do it, then I know that you're evil. I know that you're a worker of the devil. You're part of the Illuminati. You feel me? I know you're part of the Illuminati. You feel me? So I really can't fuck with you. Because you know the truth. And you still want to do evil. The wrong thing. I can't fuck with you. I can't be part of it. I can only be part of people that want to deny Jesus, sign this covenant, and want to run. Finish. Y'all can help me. Y'all can be counselors so that can counsel me and teach me things. Teach me how to be and can help me grow. Know how to, you feel me, move a church. You could teach me like, let's say, you could teach me how to properly, you know what I'm saying, move a church. You feel me? Like, you could teach me how to set up your whole church business or whatever, you know what I'm saying, the choir, you know what I'm saying, how y'all set up the choir, you know what I'm saying, set up the ushers, you know what I'm saying? The teaching. All this stuff. How you run a church. Like, you can teach me how to run a church. Because I don't know how to run a church. You know? I know the word. But I don't know how to run a church. Like, keep the church going. Like, as in, like, what y'all do. Like, the choirs, all that. I do all my stuff on the internet. You know? Now, on the internet, it's easy. I don't have to deal with the interaction with people and all that. But I know that when this thing go out and the truth is seen, I will need a church. I think I will need a main place I will minister for. I will need ushers. I will need choir directors. I will need, you know what I'm saying? I will need bishops. I will need small pastors. You know, I will need some more pastors. I don't need prophetess. I don't need apostles. I'm gonna need different type of people. I'm saying to get the house of God, man. And not just in my church. I'm gonna have other branches also when I make money on my music and on my teaching. I'm gonna do other branches and meet people to run it. And I wanna know how to properly run a church and family to keep a ministry going. Cause my whole game plan is to rebuild the ministry. You know what I'm saying? Rebuild it in the family system. Rebuild the ministry, rebuild all this stuff. You know what I'm saying? But, you know what I'm saying? I lack at those points. But when it comes to the Word of God, understanding the Bible, you know what I'm saying? I know that part. You know what I'm saying? I'm skilled in that part. I think I'm learning all that God gave me. Then you can have to perfect it to the best of my ability. You feel me? But, and that's the thing. Like, I'm not trying to be mean to nobody or rude to nobody, but I have to tell you the truth. I have to tell you guys when you guys are wrong. And not only that you're wrong, we are in a Bible prophecy that is guaranteed to come to pass. You feel me? And you are teaching the wrong teaching. You think it's right. But leading y'all to death because you're teaching vain teachings and you take it out of the gospel and you add it to the gospel. They added Jesus to the prophecy and made it look like Jesus was this and took Emmanuel out. You feel me? And that's what they did. You feel me? They added Jesus and said Jesus is Emmanuel's Savior. And they took Emmanuel out, which was the name that God was given from the beginning. You feel me? And that's crazy. And that's what I'm trying to tell people. And that's what I'm trying to tell you. Like, girl, you have to understand. Because you gotta understand. I'm not trying to diss you. But I'm not trying to diss you. Because I have to go against you. What I'm doing is going against you. I'm going against you and the corrupt teachers and the vain teaching that they've been teaching all your years. I'm going against this false man of God. You feel me? Yes, I'm going against all the false men of God. I hate them. I hate people that will take the word of God and use it falsely. I hate people that will lie to people about the word of God just for money. I hate that shit, man. I really do. It pisses me off, man. Like, for real people, it really pisses me off because I'm doing this sincerely. And for somebody to tell me that my sincerity is false because of their false lies and their false beliefs, you feel me? That is bullshit. And I hate this false man of God. And I hate any man of God that would do some false shit like that. You feel me? That they would just come to the ministry just to make money off people. You feel me? And not teach people the word of God for real. You feel me? I hate that shit, man. For real. I hate that shit. Like, I hate it with a passion. You feel me? And that's what that's what pisses me off. And that's what really makes me mad up and snap and get dumb like I do. You feel me? Because of my hatred for that shit. Like, I really do hate that shit. I really do hate that shit, bro. Like, I hate that shit, bro. That shit. Like, bro, I'm not trying to rule. I hate this shit. Like, bro. Bro, I hate this false man, bro. Like, I hate y'all. You feel? I hate the teaching of Jesus. I hate y'all. And if y'all false man of God listening to, Pastor Bobby, Pastor Mike, Pastor Tony, Pastor Dollar, all y'all members, you feel me, from the Aquafar, Team Joshua, all y'all folks, man, I hate y'all, every false man of God in the world that made money on teaching them Jesus, they've got to reach out to teaching them Jesus, they've got to really do and sound the oneness in the name of Jesus. I hate y'all. Even you, Pastor Joshua, Team Joshua, you will fall to Jesus, and Jesus and Emmanuel convince you people, I hate you with passion. You will fall, and you guys are evil, and I hate you, and I know you guys are evil, and I see your evil deeds, because I have a prophetic eye, and you will never, never in your life will you get this knowledge that I have. It don't matter what you say about me. It don't matter what you do to me, what you get people to do to me. You will never be able to give people knowledge, wisdom, and understanding like I do. You will never ever give people knowledge, wisdom, and understanding like I do. I hate y'all, and I want y'all to know. And when the time comes, I will kill y'all with a prophetic word prophesied. I will kill y'all. I will torture y'all. When we all the plagues that are in this book, I will torture you. I will torture you. I am telling you, I will torture you. I will torture you, bitch ass niggas. I'm telling you right now, I don't care what you tell people, bitch, you are not God. Because you are not God, your words ain't shit. Whatever you say to me, shit. Because none of you motherfuckers are God. You feel me? And because none of you guys are God, your words ain't shit. I will torture you. And I will show you. Because we in the same region. We all agree we in the same region. So you know you're in the skunk. Even you the devil. Even you the matter. It doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter what you say. I will torture you. Soon, and real soon, a couple more years. 5 to 10 more years. 5 to 10 more years. It will arm your government too, bro. I will torture y'all. I will torture you government leaders. I will destroy, I will kill all you government leaders. All you federal government in the United States, the federal government in the United States, I'm telling y'all, I will kill you with a prophetic word of God. I will prophesy against you, and I will kill you, and everything in the Bible will come to pass on you. I'm telling you, because that's how I operate. I'm a prophet. I move on the prophecy, and I will destroy you with the power of God. I don't care what people say, man. You feel me? But today, every sermon, every teaching I've said, will tell the whole world and will show even God that I was faithful and I was humble and I did what he told me to do. You feel me? And I spoke and I went against everything. I went against every voice. I went against everybody that rejected me, whether pastors, whether the government, whether the people, family, you know what I'm saying, whether loved ones, whether girlfriends, you know what I'm saying, whether friends, you know what I'm saying, whether homies, business partners. I went against all of them, and I stayed down. You feel me? And I don't care about them anymore. You feel me? I don't care about them anymore. Shit. You feel me? And I can stay down. I mean, I know I have a tongue. You feel me? And once my voice get heard, I'll be rich. I'll be really rich. You feel me? And that's why I come to drop for good news. You feel me? And once my voice get heard and my music, when people get tired of this bullshit ass music, and which will be real soon, guess what? They'll be looking for new music. And even when you take free traffic, people will be searching for new music. And I won the top one, and guess what? And I made my name in the independent industry as one of the top good artists in the independent industry. You feel me? And because of that, when they start looking for new artists to listen to, you feel me? Because there's no free traffic, they already know my name. You feel me? And they'll be like, oh, after every night, there's music. And they check them out, let's see what he's talking about. The family, because the independent industry is going to be asking them, because you got to see, the family's name is can't make music, it's going to come down to the independent. And I'm the top dog in the independent artist in the independent world. And guess what? My name will be called out in the list of many independent artists that make good music. You feel me? And people will type my name in. They're just like they will type other independent artists too, searching for good music. You feel me? They will start from the top independent artists right that really make good music. And they will type our names in. This is why I start trying to look for new music. Because mainstream people cannot do it. There's no free traffic. And because of that, when they type my name in, everybody will listen to our music and we're going to get huge. It's going to take a little bit, and after that, unless I get my views, fuck it. Just fuck y'all, like, fuck all of y'all, man. If all my music ride, and the niggas in 1 week, they want, like, next month, bro, I'm going to start releasing more music. Because I'm going to have a foundation of music. If I'm going to have a foundation of music, and then when I start making more music, I'm going to send it to that ready to hold it. So whenever I want to listen to the thing, it's going to be like a couple of years. Because that the music I'm going to put out right now, I think I'm going to keep the music on my page to the end of next year, 2021. I'm going to release nothing. I'm going to release some old school music, but I'm not releasing nothing to the end of 2020. Then I'll do some more music. Do some necessary music that I need. The thing like out there, fuck with my music. So now I'm gonna put some good music that y'all can just listen to right there. And then when I do that, fuck it. The thing, and then I get all this music out there, and people start searching for new music. The thing, I'm one of the top in the artists. All the promoters in Atlanta know me. The thing, and one of the top dope writers in the music business. And because of that, then people be looking for the promoter. Well, who's the top artist in there? They gonna put my name. You feel me? Girl and Deadhead and my name. And for that, and all the top promoters in Atlanta fuck me. Then women in different states, then they fuck me. And because of that, boom, people will search my name up. And then they'll look at my page. They'll listen to the music on my page. And you feel me? My music is dope music. And guess what, they would like my music, and guess what, I'm on, made it, okay. So, like, it's not like, man, I'm not trying to do all this shit, okay. Okay. And then by that time, one y'all, social media want to give me free traffic, okay, man, cause my shit's going now, I'm not gonna give a fuck, I already getting free traffic, man, like, game by game, bro, I'm not gonna give a fuck, you getting free traffic, man, bitch, I make my money straight organic beauty. Before going to my profile, you feel me? And bitch, I don't owe y'all shit. I'ma take my money, get my own shit, get my own platform, kick y'all niggas out. You feel me? Kick y'all niggas out of business. You feel me? Whether you like it, whether you don't, you are going out of business. You feel me? Whether y'all like it, whether y'all don't, y'all are going out of business. And I'm gonna be the only thing running this business, this whole world. I'm telling y'all. Y'all out of this, I don't like y'all. I'm telling you, Matt Zuckerberg, I'm gonna put you out of business. I'm telling y'all, you CEOs of Spotify, iTunes, Liam Carr, YouTube, all you folks, I'm gonna put y'all out of business for what you did to me. You don't want to make money. I'm gonna put you out of business when I make this money. For real. Remember that. You feel me? I'm gonna put y'all out of business or I'm gonna get them CEOs fired. You feel me? Y'all on y'all business, I'll buy your shit, I'll buy your platform. You feel me? But I'm not gonna buy Instagram. And Spotify, all these other streaming platforms, I'll buy all this platform. You feel me? When I make my money. You feel me? But I'm not mad, bro. You feel me? I can't be mad, bro. And that's what I'm trying to get y'all to understand. And you know, with that being said, bro. I want to rest right now, and I'll come back and talk to you later, you feel me? But y'all be blessed, man. May God bless you, may God be with you, may God prosper you. You know what I'm saying? In the name of Emmanuel, Holy Spirit God, thank you. Emmanuel, be blessed. Like I said, bro, think about what I said, bro. You know what I'm saying? Study what I said. Study about, read about from beginning, Genesis to Revelation at least once. You feel me? And ask for the moral of the story. You feel me? But if I would love to give you more information, but I can't give you more information. You feel me? This all the means that you give. You feel me? And this is what God has told me to give. And nothing more. You feel me? So, I can't give you more information. You feel me? But this is all God has told me to give. So, be blessed, man. You feel me? Be blessed.